We are taking a look at a Model X charge port door. Just had to have mine replaced as it wasn't responding to the touchscreen button door presses or charge cord handle button presses, but it would open when I pressed the key fob. What failed exactly? Well, I'm not going to do a destructive terror part yet. But there's a couple things to look at, and so it's physically it still worked, but I'm going to show you what actually failed. If I don't keep moving my tape here, I'm going to take this piece of tape off. It's like a cloth-like tape. Now I've already kind of opened it up. I was playing with it a little bit. But there are two screws here. Don't bother taking those off. You're not going to get anywhere. But I will note the poor construction, as doesn't want to focus, does it? Nope, it does not. There is a crack here, and there is a nice big crack right there. So they're using too large of screws, which doesn't help. And then I also noticed there's a little hole. I don't know if that hole got worn in or if that was a manufacturing defect. Either way, my vehicle's long out of warranty, except for battery and drive unit. So I'm going to show you what failed. Now, I already popped this over open while I was trying to figure out how to get it open. Now there is, these are sealed around the top. So if you want to get it open, it is going to be a destructive opening. You'll have to cut, maybe use a razor blade and go through there. I will do that at another time, but I'm hoping to be able to make this functional again as a spare maybe. So, if we pull apart this little rubber seal here, pull that back, I'm going to try and zoom in there. I did not clean this out yet. And just by having that open, the problem was, let's see. I don't know if you can see it in there. Just exposure. It is wet. Not just a little bit wet. Well, you can see the condensation. Right there, you see a lot of condensation. Now I've had this, it's been a long day, so this has already been, this rubber grommet's already been popped off for about 12 hours now. And that's actually allowed this to dry quite a bit. And just that little bit going through the connections and the wiring, I'm getting different readings. So whatever was shorting this out, causing the sensor to give false readings, is now currently working again. So I'm going to let this completely dry out. Today is a rain and hail day, but I'll leave this open. And I am going to, let's see, what am I going to do? I'm going to leave this in the sun. And maybe I'll just get like a hanger and hang this in front of the heat vent. There we go. A little overexposed, but there's a little water drop up there. What needle was I at? Sorry, there's just no good way to do this. Here we go, let's try that. So yeah, lots of little water droplets. Here's my part revision. Closed. Open. So we're going to leave that sit and see if, well, once it's dry, I think what I'm going to end up doing, I mean, I'll let it make sure it's thoroughly dry. And what I think I will do is either I'm going to spray something in there, a water repellent, or I might just inject an electronic safe silicon or acrylic, maybe acrylic. I'll inject some acrylic potting in there, seal it again. I should have a working charge port door. Although, don't fret, this is one of those parts that's actually fairly reasonable. Part price is $85. Install's a little pricey, $2-something. Didn't take that long, only about an hour, 45 minutes. Our mobile tech did it in my driveway, as well as replaced a key fob, because I have yet another dead key fob. These things die about once a year on me, almost exactly, only for the Model X. I'll just randomly start draining batteries. So that's going to be my next video. I'm going to be a complete teardown of the X key. See if we can, well, we're not going to find a failure point on this one. I already took it apart, so I really didn't feel like spending $2-something on another key, because this one was like a month out of warranty. All right, bye-bye.